the topic which we are studying is that how we can utilize genetic engineering in plant biotechnology. So, if we can talk about, we can talk a lot about plant biotechnology in last 3 days. We can talk about all the different plant tissue culture techniques which we are using nowadays for forestry, for horticulture, for development of plant, for agriculture, for food products. Now we are getting a glimpse of how we can utilize genetic engineering, or you can say how we can club genetic engineering with plant tissue culture and how it is beneficial for the mankind in various aspects of human welfare. So first of all, before starting genetic engineering, there are 3 most important terms. One is transgene, one is transgenesis, and another one is transgenic plants. So first of all, what is transgene? The transgene is a genetic material or a gene which we are going to transfer in a particular plant is called as transgene, or in a particular organism with the help of either direct gene transfer, or you can say natural gene transfer, or by using any gene transfer technique. How we can do it comes under the transgenesis. Okay, and third one is the transgenic plant. Transgenic plant is that particular plant in which we can transfer the gene, or more important is that the transferred gene should express in a particular plant or in a particular organism. So there is a clear distinction between transgene, transgenesis, and transgenic plant. Next is, now we can move on to the history of plant breeding, because it is very important to know that how these things start. First of all, as you all know, that breeding practices can be done in India from last 3 decades. Genetics was started by Mendel, we all know. He do cross pollination, pollen from one plant and sigma from other plant. Then he get that there are certain type of dominant plants and certain type of recessive plant. How we can use the traditional breeding? We can use the traditional breeding by increasing crop yield, by increasing resistance to pest and disease, by drought tolerance. What are the disadvantages? Long process, it may take time, lot of manpower is required, and to getting the improved traits, to getting the new variety, to getting the important characteristics is limited as in comparison to traditional agriculture rather than the genetic engineering or use of plant tissue culture as the technology. Now, another approach is mutation breeding. Treat seeds with mutation or exposed with gamma rays. We can directly treat the seeds to undergo mutation. It also has certain disadvantages. Less predictable result. We don't know whether those mutations are beneficial for us or they are harmful for us. So we cannot determine whether they are beneficial for us or they are harmful for us. Lot of manpower is required for it. It is quite successful in flower world. That is, if we are introducing new color, more petals. But when we go for characteristic feature, when we go for certain type of other changes, that this particular approach is not very successful. Now, how we can do it? We can simply take the seed. We can undergo UV treatment. Either the seed will kill or the seed will alive. If the seed will alive, we can plant it. And then we can test the improvement, whether the UV light or irradiation has any improvement on the characteristic feature of seed or not. Then we found desirable trait. If desirable trait is that, then we can test for progeny, whether it is transformed from one generation to another generation or not. Then if it is transferred, then that means it is heritable. The characteristics are transferred from one generation to the another generation. Then we can sold those improved variety of seeds in the market. So this is a quite simple approach. It is not as simple as we are talking about it. there are a lot of things which are introduced in this particular type of treatment. Then transgenic plant are insertion of foreign gene in specific plants. What is the basic difference between transgenic technology and traditional breeding? If we can look at it, in transgenic technology we can transform gene from any source, like animal, bacteria, virus. We can take anything, we can take gene from any particular organism and transfer that particular gene into the another organism. In traditional breeding, we can only move the genes within the genus of the plant. Here in transgenic technology, we can take animal gene and transfer it into the plant. We can take the plant gene of a particular species and transfer it into the plant gene of other species. But in traditional breeding, the exchange of gene or the change of gene can only take place at genus level. Now, simple about plant tissue culture, we all have studied about it. Totipotency, ability to cell to divide, explant, you all know, solid medium, you all know, liquid medium is suspension culture. Nutrient medium consists of hormone, calluses, and undifferentiated cell mass. These all we have studied, so I am not taking this slide. Now, the process of regenerating a plant from a single cell, it has three type of alterations. It may be temporary physical change, it may be epigenetic change, yani ki less change at genetic level, and it may be true genetic change. If we can see, if we can take, you can see here the leaves are like that. We can take the apical meristem, we can culture them, and single, and you can see that single cell, single apical meristem cell can create a whole plant. So the entire plant can be degenerated from a single cell, small sample of tissue, or even single plant cell may be cultured in vitro under appropriate condition and may degenerate into the complete plant. So this is what very basic tissue culture. Now we are now in this slide, we are having the callus. We can taking the nutrients and hormone. Callus is formed. From callus, shoot are formed. Shoot to root are formed, and we can plant it that into the, and we can undergo the hardening. If we, this is the callus culture in solid medium. If we can go for liquid culture, we can take liquid medium plus hormone. Single plant cell we are taking, shooting and rooting takes place, and we can harden that into the, we can harden that into the pot. So this is, one is solid culture, one is the liquid culture. In both the cases, we are only taking the single cell. Now comes the real story for which we are here today. We have studied a lot about plant tissue culture, somatic embryogenesis, haploid production, micropropagation, and all that things. But what is the actual advantage of genetic engineering or gene transfer in crop improvement, in agriculture improvement? So why gene transfer? For crop improvement, as we all know, for disease resistance, for stress tolerance, for improving the performance and value added traits. Sir has told you about edible vaccines. Nowadays we are adding pharmaceuticals or nutraceuticals as such into the food product, as such into the banana, as such into the apple. So basic study for this, we have to know about gene expression, reverse under, there are two types of genetics, as you all know. One is forward genetics, one is reverse genetics. Forward genetics is we can know, we can have the gene and we can know the phenotypic character of that particular gene. And reverse genetic is we are having unknown genes and we can have to characterize the phenotypic character of that particular gene. If we can go for gene transfer studies, we have studied about it also. There are agrobacterium, natural gene transfer, direct DNA uptake, and there are certain virus-based vectors which we are using for transferring the gene. Next, how we can use TI plasmid or Agrobacterium tumefaciens for transfer of gene. It is a gram-negative soil bacteria which naturally transform plant cells, and it can form the crown gall. I will show you the picture of crown gall or cancer. Tumor formation is the result of transfer, integration, and expression of gene on a specific segment of Agrobacterium tumefaciens plasmid DNA, which is called tDNA, or you can say it as transfer DNA. The tDNA residues on a large plasmid are called tumor-inducing plasmid, which are found in Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Next, how gene transfer can occur with the help of Agrobacterium tumefaciens. to make a segment of DNA that contains a selectable marker and a gene of interest to look the tDNA. To get the tDNA into Agrobacterium, we can mobilize the vir gene. There are vir genes which are present in tDNA to produce and find transformed plant cells that can be regenerated into normal or fertile plant. What are the requirements for Agrobacterium mediated transformation? A transfer cassette bounded by the functional boundaries. Put these cassettes into Agrobacterium as they are the expression cassettes. Disarm TI plasmid that remain functional vir gene. For making the vir gene functional, we have to disarm the TI plasmid. Next, what are the advantages? It is technically simple. Yield relatively uncomplicated insertion event, but disadvantage, it can be a disadvantage or can be a disadvantage because it has low copy number, but advantage is that minimal rearrangement. We don't have to rearrange the entire TI plasmid to insert the DNA into it. Unlimited size of foreign DNA. It is a very good advantage of this particular technique. We can insert the any size of DNA into it. Efficient for most of the plants, adaptable to different cell type, culture procedure, for protoplast, for tissue section, for null culture method. Transformants are biotically and mitotically, meiotically and mitotically stable. Disadvantage, host range is limited. Agrobacterium ke liye sare ke sare plant jo hai wo susceptible nahi hote. With susceptible plant, accessible culture regeneration system must be adapted by Agrobacterium mediated transfer. So we have to require a very specific type of culture for growing Agrobacterium. Next is infection. How we can put the infection of Agrobacterium into the host cell? Jo wounded plant cell hoti hai that releases phenolics and nutrients. Phenolics and nutrient cause chemotoxic response. Chemotoxic response banata hai Agrobacterium to infections ka. Now we can attach the bacteria to the plant cell. Certain phenol जैसे कि acetocyrinjone, hydroxytocyrinjone that induces vir region transcription. It will allow tDNA to transfer and integrate into the plant chromosomal DNA. Now tDNA is inserted into the plant chromosomal DNA. Transcription and translation of tDNA in plant cell to produce opines. It produces opines which can provide food and tumor that can provide housing for the bacteria. So the opine permease or catabolism gene of TI plasmid allow Agrobacterium tumefaciens to use opine as a CHON, CH carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen source. This is requirement for growth and development. Now what actually occurs, you can see here. Now what happened, suppose this is the plant that consists of wound that has nucleus. DNA is clipped off and it is transformed into the bacterial cell. So this is a very similar, very simple process. This is the natural type of transfer. We can do it very easily. Now if we can further look at it, you can see that opine inducer and conjugation. Opine is the source of nutrition, carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen. Here you can see that there is a TI plasmid which is inserted into the chromosomal DNA of host cell. This is the area, this is the particular area where crown gall or cancer occurs. This is the cell wall, this is the entire cytoplasm. In cytoplasm there is nucleus. Now you can see that from nucleus, poly A mRNA. You already know about post-transcriptional modification in which they are having a poly A tail and 7-methyl guanine cap. This will lead to the formation of protein. So this is the entire process by which Agrobacterium tumefaciens undergo infection and helps in the transfer of gene. If you can see, it is like that. If you can see in plants, it look like that. These are the crown gall of these are the crown gall on tobacco. We can use this crown gall for isolating tDNA, and this can be further used for transfer of genes. Now, how we can clone it? YFG is your favorite gene or a target gene in a small tDNA plasmid in E. coli. Isolate the plasmid and use it to transform. Disarm TI. This is, you can see that this is a vector. that contains origin of replication, E. coli. This is the left border, right border. This is a plant selectable marker gene. This is the target gene. And this is the selectable marker gene for both E. coli and Agrobacterium tumefaciens. You can see that here selectable marker are present. These selectable marker help in the selection. Now we can disarm the TI plasmid and it is introduced into the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. This is the chromosomal DNA. This is the Agrobacterium. We can transfer this particular thing by gene transfer into the leaf disc, and we can see that this is introduced into the plant. We can transfer the gene into the plants. Next is the structure and function of TI plasmid. As you can see that this is the promoter, this is the gene of trait. So you can see this is the open reading frame. It starts with a start codon and ends at the stop codon. Essential element for carrying a transgene on TI plasmid. The tDNA segment contains both the transgene and a selective marker or reporter gene. These have separate promoter and termination signals. You all know about this. The marker or operator gene must be expressed all the time, whereas the transgene is often expressed only in certain tissue or under certain circumstances and usually has a promoter that can be induced by appropriate signal. So this is the basic structure of TI plasmid, which contain virulence or virgin, sensitivity to agrocin, nopalin, agrocinopin. Here is the conjugation tragene, and this is the particular region where we can undergo the insertion of DNA. Auxin synthesis, cytokine synthesis, opine synthesis, and these are the border repetitive signals. Now, this is very simple. What we can do, we can take the liquid plus modified agrobacterium. We are having the callus tissue. We can transfer it into it, add neomycin, and we can infect the plant cells. Here we are using the solid culture, and here we are using the liquid culture. Procedure may be the same. So, if now what we can see, we can compare plant cell DNA delivery methods and what are the effect of them. First of all, we can see that TI plasmid gene transfer excellent and highly effective, but it is only limited to dicots. We can only use it for dicots. If we can go for micro projectable bombardment, it is very easy and effective, and it is used in wide range of plant. Viral vector, they are not very effective. Direct gene transfer into plant protoplast, it is used for only certain protozoan. Microinjection is very tedious and slow. Electroporation is only for protoplast. Liposome is very limited. It is also limited for protoplast. And there are lesser chances that it can be regenerated into the whole plant. So if we can look at this table, we can see that there are two very important methods and most widely used method. One is micro projectile bombardment and one is plasmid. Next, what is particle bombardment technology? It works with all type of plant. DNA is carried on microscopic metal particle fired by gun into the plant tissue. Here you can see that pressurized air gas chamber is there. This is the plastic bullet. This is a gold beads coated with DNA. This is the stop plate, and we can transfer this into the dish where the callus is present. This is the interstructure of this high voltage discharge, water droplets, water vapor, thin metal sheet with gold beads. DNA is encoded by these gold beads. This is the vacuum chamber. With the help of particle bombardment method. Now you can see it. DNA coated on microscopic gold beads. Beads are placed at the end of plastic bullet. Blast of helium used to project them. Plastic meshwork is used to stop the bullet. Alternative method is by strong electrical discharge. We can also do this using a strong electrical discharge. Amount of penetration into tissue can be changed. Now you can see beads enter through the cytoplasm. Now what happened after entry? Beads enter the cytoplasm of nucleus of the cell DNA is free and recombined with chromosomal DNA. Leaf transferred the selection media for cell growth. Only cells with selectable marker grow, other die. As you all know, selectable marker are used for selection process only. Transform plant are generated using tissue culture technique. Now we can use any of the tissue culture technique for transforming the plants. Screen for gene of interest. Here you can see that this is the gene. And we can transfer that particular type of organism gene which we are going to transfer in that particular character. Now next, detection. Now important, once you can transfer the gene, it is important ki you have to see that whether gene is inserted or not. We can done it with the help of selectable marker or reporter gene. Widely used reporter gene, nowadays widely used reporter gene is NPT. Neomycin phosphotransferase in activity AB neomycin by attaching a phosphate group. Cells with AB are not killed, but other cells which do not integrate with DNA. So here, by the help of selectable marker or reporter gene, we can easily distinguish among the vector in which DNA is inserted or in which DNA is not inserted. Now another approach is using of luciferase gene. Luciferase include a reporter gene coding for luciferase. Luciferase provide light with its substrate luciferin. In the presence of luciferin, luciferase produce light found in luminous creatures. Gene coding eukaryotes is LUC, and in prokaryote it is called LUX. Different chemical nature luciferin, if ATP, in the presence of ATP and oxygen, get oxidized. Use scintillation counter to give the light. Advantage, not stable for long. Active protein is directly proportional. This is a very good quality of it. Jitna aapka active protein hai, uska jo level hai, that is directly proportional to the level of gene expression. Used to test activity of a specific promoter. We can use it for testing the activity of a specific promoter. Such as CAP promoter controls the expression of LUC gene, and luciferase is only made when this promoter is turned on to the plant. So it will prove that this particular type of promoter or reporter gene is very specific for a particular type of plant. Next is how we can do it. We can put luciferase here, leave this from plant transform. Now we can view it in scintillator. Plant seedling expression, LUC gene under control promoter. Soak in luciferin, leaf glow in dark. If these leaf grow in dark, that means your gene transfer is successfully takes place. Next is Cre or LOXP system. Cre is cause recombination. It is found in bacteriophage. It is a recombinase enzyme. It recognizes 34 base pair DNA sequence LOXP site. It catalyzes recombination between two LOXP sites, placing LOXP in either side of DNA. The enclosed region may be deleted by Cre recombination. CRE gene is also included in the transgenic construct. We can include it in the transgenic construct if it is present. That means no gene. If it is absent, that means gene transfer takes place. This approach allows selected marker gene to be removed from the plant DNA after use. Once we can undergo the selection, we can remove that particular part from our gene. It can be added during the cross pollination. It is a very simple process for plant variety of tea plants released in public content. Only a single transgene of interest. It is used when we can transfer a single gene or our gene of interest is single. How we can do it? At you can see that there is a LOXP region. There are two LOXP region. There are Cre region. We can undergo looping, and you can see that Cre can be removed and only LOXP is remain in the system. The Cre protein binds to LOXP recognition site in DNA. Two nearby LOXP sites are brought together. The recombination between them eliminate the intervening DNA. The single LOXP site remain in the target DNA molecule. Simple hai bilkul. Excision karke humne Cre kar diya. Next is plant breeding and testing. How we can undergo plant breeding and testing? Evaluating and testing transformed transgenic plant is more important. Now you can see, you can undergo the transgenesis. Now how you can check whether your plant is transgenic or not? Event each independent case of transgenic integration. The location of integration affects the expression of transgene. That is very important. Transgene with no harmful effect must be moved from experimental plant to higher yield. Now you can see that if you can check that your transgenesis takes place and your transgene is expressed quality, you all know about back cross and higher yielding. This crossing will ensure 98% of genes in the final plant and from the high yielding variety, and 2% are from original transgenic plant. So you can see that by this particular approach, we can check that whether our transgenic plant provide yielding or not. Now, herbicide resistance, how we can use genetic engineering and herbicide resistance. What are herbicides? They are the chemical agents that destroy a plant or inhibit their growth. Example is glyphosate. Amino acid phosphate derivative, it is an amino acid phosphate derivative. Glycine, it is environmental friendly, break down into non-toxic compound, kills plant by blocking the synthetic pathway of aromatic amino acids, inhibit the enzyme EPSPS, 5-enol pyrovinyl shikimate 3-phosphate synthase. It is a product of ROA gene in chloroplast. It is found in plant, fungi as well as in bacteria. It is not found in animal and human beings. Now, what happened? This is shikimic acid 3. This is phosphoenol pyruvate. In the presence of ROA, it is converted into 5-enol pyrovinyl shikimate 3-phosphate. And in the presence of ROC, it is present in coricic acid. Okay, and this coricic acid will further convert it into tryptophan, some vitamins and cofactor, tyrosine, and phenylalanine. So here you can see that by this we can produce the natural herbicide resistant plant. Now, what scientists do for getting this? You can see that this is DNA. This is the promoter. This is ROA gene, this is plant promoter, and these two are the terminating codon. First of all, they found EPSPS resistant gene to glyphosate in bacteria. Bacterial terminators and sequence were replaced by plant. Bacteria wali hata ke plant wali usme introduce kar di. Chloroplast transit peptide ko add kar diya. Transit peptide ko hata diya. Only functional enzyme entered to the chloroplast. इससे क्या फायदा हुआ? सिर्फ वही particular portion chloroplast में add हुआ, which is responsible for certain type of gene expression. This glyphosate resistance gene transfer were carried out in different crops. इसको बहुत जगह करके देखा गया. इसको canola और cotton में भी करके देखा गया with the help of TI plasmid method. इसको soybean में भी करके देखा गया with the help of gene gun method. Now insect resistance, इसका तो बहुत ही अच्छा example है. Chemical used to kill insect, very costly, hazardous procedure. They are more toxic in human beings. Similar biochemical pathway in insect and human. Naturally occurring insect are only harmful to insect. Example BT toxin. You all know about BT toxin. How these toxins are used? Cotton ball worm से बचाने के लिए, European corn borer से बचाने के लिए. One destroy the cotton, another one destroy the corn. So what approach they take? Spore and crystal of toxin eaten by insect larva, crystal released, insect larva dies. You all know that as and when in BT cotton, as and when the insect bite on the particular plant, a toxin, BT toxin releases and it can kill the insect. Bacterial spores of bacillus are found on food eaten by the caterpillar. The crystalline protein is released by digested of the spore and it broke down, produce the toxin that kills the insect larva. How you can do it? Bacillus, cry protein, insect eat, cry release, dealt endotoxin, which is called betotoxin. Toxin bind to intestinal lining, holes were generated, digestive system disturbed, and death of the insect. So you can see the beauty in it. What we exactly do, we can introduce the BT BT gene into the, what we can do, we can introduce the BT gene into the cotton, and when insect bite on the cotton, cry protein release, insect eat that cry protein, it release endotoxin, endotoxin binds with the intestinal lining of the insect, it generates the hole, it disturbs the digestive system, and it will lead to the death of the insect. There are different type of cry protein which are found in bacillus. Cry 1, it kills butterfly and moth. Cry 2, it kills butterflies and flies. Cry 3, it kills beetles. Cry 4, it kills only flies. Now, what are the use of transgenic technology? Toxin gene insert into tomato plant showed partial protection. Plant made only low level of toxin. Why? Because we are taking those genes or those toxins from bacterial system. They are very active in bacteria. But when we can artificially transfer those particular genes from bacteria to the plant organism, to the plant system, their toxic level decreases. So the level of toxin, the level of effect of toxin get decreased when they are artificially transformed from bacterial system, from which they are originally generated to the plant system. Okay. Next is show use of codon is a problem. What are the problems in this? Several different codon encode the same amino acid. Different organ favor different codon on same amino acid. Have different level of corresponding tRNA. Thus, insert toxin gene was altered by changing many bases of the third position of redundant codon. 20% of its bases were altered to make it more plant-like in codon using. You can always see that suppose there is a gene that has a particular characteristic feature in particular organism, and you are transferring that particular gene into the another organism. Then it is not sure that that particular gene can show same type of expression as it is showing in the host organism. So here the important thing is that at what capacity and how much type of expression can be shown by a particular gene when it is transferred from one organism to the another organism. Next is stress tolerance. Stress are drought, high salinity, that are the two major type of stress. In drought-tolerant plant, fungi, bacteria, sugar, thiolase protect organism during the stress. Now, what is thiolase? It is a non-reducing sugar carbohydrate. It absorbs and releases the water. Kaise? You can see that there are UDP glucose and glucose 6-phosphate. That is thiolase phosphate synthesis. That synthesizes the thiolase 6-phosphate and releases UDP. That thiolase 6-phosphate phosphatase can release phosphate and form the thiolase. Then this thiolase in the presence of 3-alase enzyme can lead to the formation of 2 glucose and decrease the problem of salinity into the area where there is less amount of water. Now, functional genomics in plant. What is the role of functional genomics in plant? You can see these techniques are used to screen the entire genome. You have studied it very well in bioinformatics part. Most rely on removal and blockage of gene expression. Model to know the function of plant genes are either we can do it by insertion, or it we do it by gene silencing, or we can do it by fast neuron mutagenesis. And there is one very important technique which is called as TILing, target induced local lessons in genomes. How we can do it by insertion, method to find function of new gene, transposon or tDNA insertion are used to generate plant mutants. What are transposons? Jumping genes. tDNA includes only a proper reporter gene, cloned upstream and downstream of the insertion, plant gene identified, inserted into plant chromosome, disrupt the plant gene, and the phenotype which is generated can be screened and assessed. Next is gene silencing. In this, we can use the technology which is called RNAi. RNAi is triggered by double-stranded RNA, which is cut into short segment, that is siRNA. Now there is our enzyme complex with the presence of siRNA, identified homologous RNA, cut it and prevent the expression of mRNA in the protein. Next is fast neutron mutagenesis. In this, we can generate gene knockouts. First, neutrons are used to induce DNA deletion. सबसे पहले DNA को delete करते हैं. One MeV kinetic energy are generated. These neutrons cause deletion of exposed DNA. Seed treated with fast neutrons are called M1 seeds. They are first treatment. इसके बाद एक और करेंगे उनको M2 seeds कहेंगे. M1 seeds grow into plant. Each plant has different deletion. M2 seeds collect DNA into pools of varying size. So by this we can check the expression and check whether the gene transfer goes on in a well-defined manner or not. कैसे? These are M1 type of seeds. These are M1 cynosine. These are fast neurons. These are transferred into the plant. Now we can harvest M2 seeds. In this, we can put in seeds or harvest DNA from each plant. Now we can harvest that particular DNA from each plant, which we can get from M2 seeds, mix DNA into large small pools, and undergo the PCR analysis. And if in PCR analysis we can get the desired gene product, then it will confirm that our DNA transfer or gene transfer occurs in a good manner. Now tilling. Tilling is target induced local lesions in genome. How we can undergo the tilling? First, seed are soaked in chemical mutagens. We can take the seeds and soaked in chemical mutagens. This induces GC and AT transition of DNA. These are M1 seeds. They grow into plant. M2 seeds are produced. DNA is harvested. ये पहला वाले procedure जैसा हो गया. PCR primer are used to amplify the selected region of DNA. Now we use PCR primer and undergo PCR. The PCR product which we'll get is labeled into two. Heteroduplexes of mutant and wild type DNA are created from that. We can cleave the PCR product, Cal1. It also has a label. We can add certain fluorescent into the PCR product. Uncleaved DNA will have both fluorescent label. देखिए, there are two sides. On one side, fluorescence is there. On other side, attachment is there. If attachment occurs, no fluorescence. If attachment does not occur, there is a fluorescence. Tested mutant strands can be identified by gel electrophoresis. Then we can identify the digested mutants or the digested product with the help of agarose gel electrophoresis. Now you can see here. Soak MI seeds, plant बना लिए, M2 seeds बना लिए, DNA harvest कर लिया, DNA जो harvested DNA है उसका PCR कर लिया, इसको fluorescent tag से label कर लिया, जो hybrid है वो mismatch हो गए, and hybrid का formation हो गया cell 1 से digest करने के बाद. Food safety and starting corn. First of all, it is very important to know the difference between transgenic crop and genetically modified crop. So if we have checked, then we can see that transgenic crop is more accurate than the genetically modified crop. In a genetically modified crop, we can also transgenic plant. Allergenic potential of transgenic crop has caused much controversy. Starlink, an unapproved transgenic corn, was detected in taco shell. Transgene Cry9C is more resistant to stomach acid. Transgenic corn was mixed with other corn and sent to the market. Split approval given by EPA and 123 sent to market, and allergic reaction were reported by the public. You can see that a transgenic corn can be used, and allergic activities reported among the persons who are using that particular transgenic corn. Center of Disease Control examined the blood sample of public and concluded that that allergic reaction was not due to Cry9C protein. The allergic activity was not due to transgenic protein. All standing seed and product were called back from the market. BT toxin and butterfly. General nature suggested that monarch butterfly were killed by eating pollen from corn carrying BT gene. The result of the controversy. Now you can see that. You can see that that allergy is not because of Trin-9C gene. Same case is here. The result of controversy was search of research of transgenic BT plant and their effect on the butterflies and not target organ. Harmful pollen were Cry1AB event 176 in 2000. Cry1AB were only toxic to monarch caterpillars at density greater than 1000 pollen grain per square centimeter. Cry1F and 9C showed the non-toxic effect. Studied were done in labs where caterpillar had to eat only milkweed contaminated with the pollen. So these are not the controversies. You can see that one more problem can come in BT toxin. As you all know that the seeds of BT cotton are haploid. So they are having the terminator technology. Here, every year when you have to cultivate the crop, you need the new seeds. But in traditional agriculture, the farmers are using the seeds repeatedly. So the viability of that viability of those seeds get decreased. So in that case, the poor farmer gets poorer and rich farmer who are purchasing the seeds every year get richer. But these are the myths, because in India you all know that there are lot of ethical issues. Some people considered BT cotton as non-veg. Some people considered BT brinjal as non-veg. But it is not like that. Now, why altering the plant? First, plant productivity. How you can increase the plant productivity? By tolerance to stress, pathogens and herbicide. How you can increase the nutritional value? By increasing protein, amino acid and lipid. How we can produce new and modified plant? By recombinant protein production. We can also undergo the metabolic pathway regulation by nutrient capture, by carbohydrate production, by essential oil production. We can use it in pharmaceutical compound by producing antibodies, plantibodies, vaccines, therapeutic proteins, by phytoremediation in pollution control, removal of pollution, soil tolerance, by novel traits such as fruit ripening, flower coloring, by agronomic traits such as seed dormancy, disease resistance against bacteria and fungi, and in nematode resistance. So we can, why we need to alter the plant, why we need to enter the transgene to the plant, why there is a need of transferring the gene into the plant. So here are all the applications of genetic engineering of transgenesis for improving the crop, for improving the variety of the plant, and use this for the human welfare. So this is all about for today. If you have any questions, then you can ask it.